weight initialization techniques. So normally we initialize all the weights randomly. All the weights here that you see, every one of these connections have a weight and they are initialized randomly. For biases, they're initialized to zero most of the time. So they are set to be zero and weights are not set to be zero, because if we do that, then they're all going to be updated at the same time or in the same manner. So then this whole network is only going to be like as good as one neuron. So that's why we initialize the weights to be random. But we will see in the next lessons that we have a problem called the unstable gradients problem. And we'll talk more about what that problem is and how to solve them. But one of the solutions to it is change how you initialize the weights. One option, for example, one example is to change the weights, still initialize the weights still randomly, but the variance of these randomness is going to change. So there are some details that we will talk about later, but just so you know, weight initialization is also something, a hyperparameter that you can set to deal with some of the problems that neural networks come with. The last one is regularization. So as I said, regularization is a way to cancel out some of the neurons. So you might say, okay, I'm not going to care about these little guys here for this run. This makes for a more simple network, and we normally use this to deal with overfitting. Again, we will go more detail into this while we're talking about overfitting in neural networks, and regularization has its own parameters also. So you can choose what kind of regularization that you want. There are a bunch of kinds. You can choose the parameters of each of these regularization techniques. So that's why it's something a little bit, something that we need to look into a bit in more detail after this lesson. All right, so the next thing that we're going to talk about is overfitting in neural networks, what it is and how we can solve that problem and which techniques to solve that problem. As you've also seen here, regularization is one of them. So let's jump to the next lesson and learn about overfitting and how to deal with it.